Hi, this is Ryan Rey, and in this video I'm going to be looking at polyrhythm. So what this is when you have two or more rhythms happening simultaneously. It could be something like 2 against 3 or 4 against 3, things like that. So what does that mean? Well, in the case of 4 against 3, that would mean having 4 evenly spaced notes over the same space as 3. And then the same thing for 3 against 2 would be 3 evenly spaced notes over the space of 2. So I'll show you what that sounds like. So 4 against 3, I'm gonna play 3 beats with my left hand and 4 in my right. So. So you can see that for every 3 that I tap with my left hand, I have 4 over the same amount of time, and they're all evenly spaced. If I do 3 against 2, I'll do 2 with my left, 3 with my right. So you can see that the composite rhythm is much more interesting when you have these polyrhythms happening. So for the examples in this video, I'm mostly going to be looking at 4 against 3. So one way that you can remember this, if you're already going, how am I going to remember 4 against 3? There's a fun sentence that you can say over this that goes, pass the goddamn butter, pass the goddamn butter, pass the goddamn butter. I also learned pass the goddamn spinach, which is a little bit different, but whatever works for you helps you to internalize this as well as perform it with your hands with more steadiness. If we look at this on a grid or on some notation, it'll look like this. So with 4 against 3, we can see we have 3 quarter notes notated, and above it are 4 dotted eighth notes. So what that value equals is 3/16th notes, while a quarter note is 4/16th notes. When you put the dotted eighths above the quarters, you can see that you can fit 4 of them over the same amount of space as 3. We can also represent this on a grid, showing the same placement of these, with the bottom row showing the quarter note or the group of 3, and the top row showing the dotted eighths or the group of 4. And you'll see that they realign after each cycle. So after you do 3/4, you then start again, and then you have another group of 3 and another group of 4. So something to keep in mind with these polyrhythms are when you're speaking in terms of 3 against 2 or 4 against 3, the number on the right is where you're going to find your beat. So if I have 4 against 3, the 3 portion is where we're going to hear our main beat. But that doesn't necessarily mean that our meter is in 3. So these examples aren't just for songs or examples that are, you know, a waltz or something in 3. This can be something that is in 4/4, or, you know, kind of a common time feel. And each cycle of 3 quarter notes, it's going to start over again, or something else will happen. And in the case of these examples that I'm going to be looking at, we're going to find that that's more of the case. So the first two examples that I'm going to play are using kind of a basic use of the 4 against 3 polyrhythm. The first 3 beats in these use this 4 against 3, with the 4th beat of the measure being something more straightforward, either 2/8 notes or 4/16, or something to kind of turn it back around so that at the next measure, we're kind of back at the start again. So the first one is We Found Love. So we can see for this one that the 4-against-3 polyrhythm happens for the first 3 beats of the measure, and then that 4th beat of the measure just realigns it so that every meter starts over, and it's pretty straightforward. And you find that in the chords, while the vocals just kind of play through a regular rhythm. So another one that kind of does the same style, where we have this kind of alignment within one measure, is in Ellie Goulding's Burn. And we're gonna let it burn, 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 burn. We're gonna let it burn, 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 burn. Gonna let it burn, 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 burn. We're gonna let it burn, 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 burn. You don't wanna leave. So for this one, we can see that it's the same kind of use of 4-against-3 in the first 3 beats, and then the 4th beat kind of bringing it back to the beginning again. But it's in the vocals this time, instead of just being in the background music that we saw in the first example. But it's still pretty straightforward, kind of nice, easy use of this 4-against-3. The next couple examples take this kind of use, but provide a little bit of variation or some differentiation just to kind of spice it up. So this next one is I Need Your Love. And in this case, it's still the 4-against-3 for the first 3 beats, but the melody has a little bit of movement to it. So it's actually smaller fragments of these little melodic ideas. So let's listen to this one, I Need Your Love. So you can see in this case that it's still got that 4-against-3 sound, but instead of it just being one note articulated for each of the notes for the 4 group, it's like a 16th and an eighth, 16th and an eighth, 16th and an eighth. And so that ends up equaling the same amount of time of a dotted eighth note. Now this next one is This Is What You Came For, and this also uses the same kind of grouping that we're seeing with this 4-against-3, where it's the first 3 beats of a measure and then that 4th beat is something else. However, in this case, it's not just repeating the same type of pattern, it's actually having a slight adjustment to the way it's presented in one measure and then kind of straightening out in the next measure. So we can see that the variation in this use of the polyrhythm turns this one measure idea into something that's truly a 2 measure length of a pattern. So we have the first measure having just that slight variation where there's kind of a note that leads in the middle of the phrase. And then on the second repetition of it, it's more straightforward. So when you put the two together, it feels like one larger idea or one longer phrase. And it makes it just a bit more interesting to listen to at length. The other thing is we're getting a variation on how the use of the rhythm is coming through. On the first half of that example, you heard that it was the vocals and the music kind of punctuating that polyrhythm. But on the second half of the example, when it switches back into a verse, we hear that the vocals change, but the backing track is still kind of pulsing that polyrhythm throughout. So it's always there throughout the track, but it just kind of comes out in different ways and is accentuated at different times. This third example from these ones that are kind of using variation, this one kind of takes that idea of making longer phrases or longer ideas and presents the polyrhythm first as kind of straightforward, first 3 notes, and then, you know, the 4th note of the measure, kind of bringing it back around. But that'll happen twice, and then the 3rd time we hear kind of a variation like we saw in the Calvin Harris I Need Your Love, where there's kind of a melodic figuration in there. And then on the 4th repetition, it's returned back to kind of the straightforward one note articulation. So in the end, we kind of get this A, A, B, A type of rhythmic structure here, which makes it a much longer phrase and really sounds interesting. So this is Kehlani's Distraction. So in there you can hear how the words are really what's helping bring out that interesting figuration. So it's the do ya section where it's do ya, do ya, do ya. Because of the two words there, it ends up making that articulation happen. So makes that much more interesting section. So all those examples so far have been polyrhythm that is fit into one measure of 4-4 and being kind of run through the three beats and then that fourth beat cleaning up the rest to kind of turn it back around. These next examples keep going. They don't actually stop after three beats. It just starts the next round of that four against three so that it's continually going through and sometimes crossing over the bar line into the next measure of four. So for this one, we're gonna see that it just slightly goes into the next measure, making it kind of an interesting starting point. So this is Hailee Steinfeld's Starving.
You know just what to say. Things that scare me, I should just walk away. But I can't move my feet. The more that I know you, the more I want to. Something inside needs change. I was so much younger yesterday.
So we can see in this example that the four against three polyrhythm continues on and actually crosses over the bar line into the next measure of each of these phrases. And it's really driven by the lyrics. So we can hear that it's just kind of carrying through because of that and providing just an interesting sounding phrase. So for this last example, this one also takes the four against three polyrhythm and continues on a lot longer to cross over the bar lines, creating a much longer phrase and longer groove. So this is Zed's Follow You Down. So we can see in this example that the four against three polyrhythm carries over for nearly two measures. And it's just that final beat of the second measure when there's kind of this correction or a shortening of the phrase so that it can start over again. And as a result, it just kind of makes a longer idea, sounds interesting, and carries the groove through. While the use of polyrhythm is mechanically precise and seemingly rigid, we can see from these examples that the technique can provide some interest to a song as well as making the emotional quality a bit more interesting and pull it forward. So I hope that helped clarify a couple things about polyrhythm. Let us know what you think in the comments. There's lots of songs out there, plenty more examples. So if you have some that you like, that you recommend checking out, let us know in the comments and we'll see you next time. All right, thanks, bye.
If you're a music producer, subscribe to our channel and stay up to date on the latest Pyramind tutorial videos, track breakdowns, elite sessions, and more. Visit us at pyramind.com.